Now, path of projectile, which is also known as trajectory, trajectory of projectile. Trajectory means path. This is an analysis skill topic where you will deal with comprehension skill and as well as analysis skill. You have to apply that in various fields like football, cricket, long jump, high jump. Everywhere you can apply this. The previous one was recall skill. This also you can recall. From this topic for the 11th class, numericals and derivations are very, very important. But you need to understand the importance of skills. There are three skills on which you will be assessed. That is recall skill, where you will be required to answer the theoretical part, laws, units, etc. Where is an application skill or comprehension skill, you need to analyze. Comprehension analysis skill, you need to analyze and apply the concept properly in comprehension analysis skill. And the third one, that is application skill, will let you apply the concept on various given topics. It can be a numerical, it can be applied concept. So on these three bases you will be assessed, and I am giving you assignment on the basis of that. That is recall skill. Once again I am repeating, recall skill, comprehension and analysis skill, and third one is application skill. So be careful about it. Now let us discuss path of projectile. One more thing, when I will be giving you attendance Google form, I will ask you two questions answer. You have to answer on that Google form two questions which I will discuss in the videos, in the lectures which I am giving you. Somewhere in the lecture I will mention that question. You have to write only the answer and submit it. This is to take attendance subject wise. So I will send the Google form. You all have to write your name, roll number, class section, and write the answer of two questions. I will write question number one, you have to write the answer. I will write question number two, you have to write the answer. I will discuss that question in the lecture. So be careful and be prepared to watch the video properly. Now this is path of projectile. So I have told you that projectile is two-dimensional motion. So let us consider y-axis. This is along x-axis. This is along y-axis. Now this point is point of projection. An object is projected at an angle from this point with velocity u. This is the initial velocity, and the angle which it makes with the horizontal is theta. Now you can see, if you throw an object along this direction at an angle theta, it will cover vertical distance as well as horizontal distance. This is P dash. This is the height. You can see that velocity is always directed tangentially because it is velocity vector. Acceleration due to gravity is acting downward. Velocity. And द डिस्टेंस कवर्ड अलॉन्ग एक्स एक्सिस यू आर थ्रोइंग फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट ऑफ प्रोजेक्शन इट इज फॉलोइंग एट दिस पॉइंट सो डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ प्रोजेक्शन एट द पॉइंट एट विच द ऑब्जेक्ट फॉल्स इज नोन एज रेंज आई विल डिनोट इट बाई आर दिस इज द वर्टिकल हाइट कवर्ड बाय द प्रोजेक्टाइल So this is how we will draw the diagram projecting an object with an angle theta and with initial velocity u. Now I will take the two components. I will resolve this velocity into two components. This is along x-axis and this is along y-axis. So what will be the component of u along x-axis? Component of u along x-axis. I have told you, along x-axis it is making horizontal component which is u cos theta. Ux is u cos theta. And what is vertical component? Vertical component is always in terms of y, that is u sin theta. When you are projecting an object at an angle theta, you can see that it is covering some vertical distance as well as along horizontal. So it covers motion along two dimension. This is the best example, that is projectile motion. Now you need to find the path of projectile. It seems like a parabola, but you have to justify. You have to justify that this path is parabolic. So let us consider, I have already told you that vertical motion along y-axis is with variable velocity, that is accelerated motion, and horizontal motion uniform velocity. So you all know that equation of motion is applied only on accelerated motion. So when we will use vertical motion, we will use equation of motion, that is accelerated motion. And if we are using horizontal motion, when a body is moving with uniform velocity, you need to use only the formula of speed is equal to distance upon time. So here in time t, the distance covered horizontally. First, we will discuss about horizontal motion. In time t, the distance covered horizontally with velocity ux, which is a constant, and ux you know u cos theta. So here speed is equal to distance upon time. So distance is equals to speed into time, that is ux into t. And because this distance is along x-axis, so I am considering it as x. So t is equals to x by ux. This is your equation number, or you can write it as x upon u cos theta. This is your equation number one. This is motion along horizontal. Now vertical motion. In the same time, in the same time, Vertical motion is with variable velocity. Now vertical motion is with variable velocity, and in the same time we will calculate in the next lecture.